The Trump administration has been roiled by chaos, and today Trump doubled down on that chaos by holding a bizarre press conference full of false claims, grievances, and attacks on the media. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. So, our show tapes at 6:30, and usually we start writing a closer look the night before. By 1 p.m. today, we had a draft about Republican attempts to repeal Obamacare that we felt good about. And then Donald Trump held what can only be described as a bat crazy press conference that rendered this script completely meaningless. So, if you don't mind, bye, dead jokes. Now, to set the scene for this press conference, in just over 3 weeks, Trump's White House has been plagued by infighting, legal challenges, messy executive orders, the resignation of his national security advisor, and now the revelation that his aides had contacts with Russia during the campaign. And if there's been anything good in this, it's been watching Trump develop techniques to avoid questions about that Russian contact. Here's a move called the drift away.
Mr. President, are you answering questions about your associate's contact with the Russians during the campaign?
And here's another one. Here's another one called the pretend I don't hear you.
Any comment on the report that there was contact with your senior advisor that was suspected by the Russian during the presidential campaign?
Not only does Trump look miserable, but check out Bibi Netanyahu. He has a face like, should I go? Being a world leader sitting with Trump right now is like being a woman on a date with a guy, and then his wife shows up screaming, your kids want to know where you are! I just got out to dinner. This may come as a surprise to Donald Trump, but it turns out the demands of actually governing are much more strenuous than the free-for-all atmosphere of campaigning, which may be why at White House events and meetings with foreign leaders, Trump keeps reliving the glory days of his election victory.
We are, you know, very honored by the victory that we had, 306 electoral college votes. We were not supposed to crack 220. You know that, right? We won by a very, very large electoral college vote. We had a wonderful election, didn't we?
We did well. The election, it came out really well. Next time, we'll triple it up or quadruple it, right?
That's right.
We want to get over 51, right? At least 51.
Amen.
Well, this is Black History Month.
Good segue, dude. Talked about his election victory at an event for Black History Month. In fact, did you guys know Frederick Douglass voted for me? Very alive. Great guy. In fact, Trump is so desperate for the instant gratification of cheering crowds that this weekend, he's responding to all the chaos in his government by heading back out to the campaign trail less than 4 weeks into his presidency.
The president's answer to all of this? Announcing overnight his first re-election campaign rally, scheduled for this weekend in Florida.
The White House says the president will hold a rally on Saturday down in Florida. Officials here are calling it a, quote, campaign event, Wolf. So take note, Democrats, the 2020 campaign apparently has already begun.
No! No! We are not ready for another campaign. People from the last campaign are still wandering around in the woods. You're like somebody who wants a birthday month. Your birthday is over. Get to work. Because if you start talking about 2020, it's only a matter of time until CNN puts up a countdown clock, and I am not watching the same clock for 4 years. But Trump apparently couldn't wait until Saturday to get in front of the cameras because today he held his first solo press conference as president, and he used the opportunity to strike a more conciliatory tone with the media.
The press, honestly, is out of control. The level of dishonesty is out of control. It's all fake news. Fake news, fake news. Very fake news. Russia is fake news. Quiet, quiet, quiet. Sit down. Sit down. A very insulting question. Wait a minute. I don't have to tell you. I don't have to tell you. I'm not going to tell you. I'm just telling you. You know, you're dishonest people. Where are you from?
BBC.
Okay. Here's another beauty. Donald Trump rants and raves at the press. I'm not ranting and raving.
Did you hear him? He said he's not ranting and raving. But again, what president hasn't had to say, I'm not ranting and raving? Who can forget Lincoln's tirade at Gettysburg or FDR's fireside meltdowns? And of course, Ronald Reagan's famously saying, Mr. Gorbachev, if you don't tear down this wall, I'm gonna lose my Of course, it was Trump himself who spent the entire press conference whining about perceived grievances and slights and pushing false claims with zero basis in reality. Just to give you an idea of how all over the place this press conference was, at one point, Trump made this bizarre claim about the drug problem.
Drugs are becoming cheaper than candy bars.
I think I know what happened here. Donald, that's not the price, that's the name. Trump then claimed amazingly that his former national security advisor, Michael Flynn, who Trump fired, did nothing wrong when he secretly discussed sanctions with the Russian ambassador. In fact, Trump even said that if Flynn had not contacted the Russian ambassador, Trump would have ordered him to do it himself.
I don't think he did anything wrong, but certainly would have been okay with me if he did it. I would have directed him to do it if I thought he wasn't doing it.
He did something I would have told him to do, so he had to go. Clean out your desk, buddy. Why are you cleaning out your desk? Finally, Trump did answer some questions about Russia, specifically some questions about the provocative actions Russia's taken recently, from deploying a missile in violation of a treaty to sending a spy ship near a naval base in Connecticut.
You mentioned the vessel, the spy vessel off the coast of the United States.
Not good.
There was a ballistic missile test that many interpret as
not
a violation
good.
Of an
not
agreement
good.
Between the two countries, and a Russian plane buzzed a U.S. destroyer.
Not good.
That's your answer? We're talking about Russian military aggression, not a turkey sandwich at the deli. Not good. Very dry. Not good. Won't pay. Send back. And then later, he casually mused about how great it would be for him politically if he attacked the Russian ship.
The greatest thing I could do is shoot that ship that's 30 miles offshore right out of the water. Everyone in this country is going to say, oh, it's so great.
Nobody would say that. The only way everybody is going to say, oh, that's so great, is if the Russian hooker tape is on Netflix this weekend. Trump then took a question from veteran journalist April Ryan of American Urban Radio Networks, who asked if Trump would be willing to meet with the Congressional Black Caucus. And Trump offered this pretty racist response.
Are you going to include the Congressional Black Caucus and the Congressional
Well,
Hispanic
I would.
Caucus
I tell you what. Do you want to
well
set up the meeting? Do you want to set up the meeting?
No.
Are they friends of yours?
It's racist to assume all black people know each other. You don't know all orange people. Hey, Donald. Can you set up a meeting with Snooki and the Lorax? Let's talk about trees and tanning. But don't worry. Trump made sure to offend multiple demographics because when a reporter for a Jewish publication asked Trump about anti-Semitism in the U.S., Trump said this.
You see, he said he's going to ask a very simple, easy question. And it's not.
It's an important
question. It's not a simple question, not a fair question. Okay, sit down. I understand the rest of your question. We did very well relative to other people running as a Republican. Quiet, quiet, quiet. See, he lied about he was going to get up and ask a very straight, simple question. So, you know, so you should take that instead of having to get up and ask a very insulting question like that.
It's very rude to insult someone. Now sit down and shut up, you liar. Even when Trump put aside all of his bizarre paranoia, false claims, and complaints about the media and turned to actual policy, he didn't seem very comfortable. For example, Trump claimed that Republicans were working on a plan to repeal and replace Obamacare and said this.
We've begun preparing to repeal and replace Obamacare.
Wait. There's a secret Obamacare? Does it travel back in time like a DeLorean? And if so, can we fire up the flux capacitor and get that up to 88 miles an hour immediately? This has been a closer look.